This Funky Kong is controlled by an artificial intelligence in the game Mario Kart Wii, and the AI is designed to improve over time through trial and error. The longer it trains, the better it will get. With enough training, it should be able to continually learn each new track, to use items, and it might even be able to complete the entire game. At least that's the theory. I've already tried to build this AI before, but it was unable to complete 19 tracks, although I still think it has some potential to complete them all. So about 2 months ago, I decided to give this project one last chance, and to offer the AI an opportunity for revenge. This video is the conclusion of a 3-year journey to make an AI that could beat the entire game of Mario Kart Wii. And this time, it got much better than I had expected. So where did it all go wrong with my previous AI? Why was it not able to beat the game's hardest tracks? I needed to know what was causing this and how to fix it. The first major issue I noticed was the reset threshold. Here's how it works. While the AI is driving, we want the AI to be as productive as possible, which means avoiding situations such as the AI being stuck in a corner. The reset threshold is what determines whether the AI should continue driving or call it quits for that attempt. But why exactly was this causing such an issue on harder tracks? After a few days of crunching the numbers, it came down to 3 main issues. Number 1, falling off the edge. If the AI made a minor mistake, or even so much as got hit by an item at the wrong time, this would cause the attempt to end immediately. As harder tracks like Rainbow Road usually have more edges, this led to an unfair bias against those tracks. This ultimately led me to remove this condition entirely. The second and third reset conditions both essentially try to answer the same question. What conditions show that the AI is no longer being productive? I spent a while engineering some complicated solution, but this still just didn't really seem to work. Instead, I decided to just be as lenient as I could in order to hand as much power as possible to the AI. The only reset condition I decided to use was that the AI had to make around 1 second's worth of progress every 15 seconds. While the AI would certainly spend some more time being unproductive, my hope was that the AI could actually learn to try and recover from those bad situations. However, the reset threshold was far from the AI's only problem on hard tracks. In fact, I found a much, much more problematic issue. The way this AI learns is by getting rewards for hitting checkpoints around each track. These rewards are the sole driver of the AI, meaning wherever the rewards are, that's what the AI will focus on. This was terrible news for my last AI, as it put exactly 200 checkpoints per lap on every different track. This meant that even tiny tracks and ultra long tracks had the same number of rewards. The reason this is such a huge issue is because it means the rewards will be much further apart on long tracks. To put this into perspective, this meant the AI was being given less guidance on harder tracks. While there seemed to be a simple fix of just making the number of rewards match the length of the track, it left me wondering, how exactly do I get the length of the track? I mean, it's not like I was about to crawl around each track with a tape measure, so I had to come up with a better solution. I eventually settled on using the world record time for each track as a rough guide for the length of the track. When doing this though, I had to make sure to use a category of world record called No Glitch, as there are some world records that use exploits to finish tracks much faster. As a final decision, the number of checkpoints on each lap would be 100 multiplied by the world record time in minutes. The next major issue was finding a way to determine which track I should send the AI to after finishing each race. This turned out to be quite complicated, and had a real tendency to prevent the AI from learning on the hard tracks. Let's imagine the AI was sent to a random track after every race. The AI will certainly spend a long amount of time on the tracks it was good at, but then might get instantly reset on a hard track that it doesn't like. This would further bias the AI's training data, causing a vicious cycle, causing it to fail more on harder tracks. In my previous AI, I kind of solved this by tracking how long the AI spent on each track, and would then send the AI to the track it had spent the least time on. While this was a mediocre fix, I had to ask, should the AI really be spending the same amount of time on each track? I concluded that what I really needed was to force the AI to play more on tracks where it made less progress. The formula I used ended up being a little complicated, but long story short, the AI would be forced to play the tracks that it was failing at. Lastly, I made the biggest of all changes to the AI. My previous AI used an artificial neural network, which is a mathematical tool which roughly mimics how the human brain works. This network takes in the four most recent images of the screen, 15 times per second. In response, it outputs new numbers, specifying which action it wants to perform. However, a major limitation of this approach was that it had no memory. This would be no issue for my new AI. I introduced a new architecture called a long short-term memory unit. This would fundamentally change the way that the AI plays the game. This architecture allows the AI to choose what things it wants to remember and learn what to remember over time. For example, if the AI is stuck, the recent four frames may tell it nothing about where it is. The old AI would have had no clue what to do, whereas our new AI has the capacity to remember how it got there and how it can get out. Now, with all of these changes in place, be sure to hit the like and subscribe button, as it's time to see if I can train this AI to complete Mario Kart Wii once and for all. After just a single hour of training, the AI has already learned to cover the first stretch of road on almost every track. This is far better than my first attempt years ago. This AI is forced to learn to be very general rather than just trying to learn a single track. While its driving skills are quickly improving though, it learns a very interesting strategy. Slipstreaming? Driving backwards? No, the AI just loves the bullet bill. So much so that sometimes it tries to activate it before the item has even stopped spinning. This causes the AI to not use the bullet, so the AI clearly still has some issues to work through. After just 10 hours, the AI is already learning to make its way around many of the easier tracks. It certainly isn't winning any world records just yet. It just stumbles its way through many of the tracks. Here we can really see the AI's memory having a huge impact though. The AI keeps getting itself into these crazy situations, but due to its memory, it's often able to find its way out. Despite this though, the AI's lack of experience is clearly having a major impact. This is more apparent on tracks with more unique layouts and open spaces such as Maple Treeway. The AI will certainly need more time to master these map nuances. After a single day of training, the AI is making staggering progress. While the AI frequently still gets a little confused about which way to turn, it almost always finds its way back. It even manages to complete nearly two whole laps of GBA Bowser's Castle 3, one of the longest tracks in the game. But like I mentioned, it still has major weaknesses, particularly in its pathfinding abilities. This is as a result of the AI's priorities with respect to the rewards I gave it. Since I was no longer sending the AI back to the start via a reset threshold, I introduced some other ideas. To avoid the AI driving off-road and into walls, the AI was punished severely for doing these things. This led the AI to prioritize just driving somewhere, even if that meant backwards. Despite this though, the AI was still being rewarded for hitting checkpoints, which it wouldn't get if it was driving in the wrong direction. This meant eventually the AI should surely learn to drive in the correct direction. Whilst progress was looking very strong on most tracks though, of course, not all of them would be so easy. Rainbow Road was still proving extremely challenging, so the fight is far from over. After over 2 days of training, the AI is finally able to figure out its issues with Daisy Circuit and was even able to complete many different courses. When looking at this graph, however, things can be a little deceiving. Since we changed the number of rewards to be based on the track's length, even if the AI can always complete a short track like Ghost Valley, it will always get fewer rewards since there are just fewer checkpoints. Long tracks, however, like GBA Bowser's Castle, have many checkpoints, making the AI appear to be disproportionately good at these tracks. At 50 hours, the real pattern we can see is what I like to call failed progression. On harder tracks like Wario's Goldmine, the AI is slowly but consistently able to make its way around the track, albeit constantly bumping into walls, falling off, and everything in between. Since the reward for getting around the track is just so much greater than everything else, it leads the AI to just not really care if it takes a beating along the way, so long as the attempt doesn't end. After 100 hours of training, the AI is starting to look really solid on the easier tracks. On Yoshi Falls and other similar tracks, the AI has even become competitive with the game's hard CPU. It's worth noting that the game's own CPU follows a script-based algorithm, which uses information the player does not have access to. Additionally, I'm not sure exactly how much the game's CPU cheats. This is quite contrasting with this reinforcement learning-based AI, which is entirely self-taught and only uses information that the player has access to. While we provide it with rewards, we don't give it any actual guidance on how to get those rewards. The AI has to learn that for itself. But most importantly, how is it getting on with the game's hardest tracks? The AI is now managing a decent chunk of Rainbow Road, but it gets really stumped at the section following the two big rings. In fact, the AI has now completed every track beside Rainbow Road and N64 Bowser's Castle. Over the coming days, it's time to see if all the work we put into making sure that AI can do those harder tracks will finally prove enough to beat the entire game. I'm going to quickly go over the next hour blocks here, as the changes on the easier tracks are very minimal. By 150 hours, the AI is still having real trouble with those two tracks. However, our prioritization algorithm to make the AI play more of the tracks it's bad at is really starting to kick in hard. The AI is now spending almost 80% of its time playing exclusively Rainbow Road. By 175 hours, the AI is looking strong at the first section of the track, but is petrified of the Dark Abyss after the two big rings. The AI seems to be sure it just cannot pass that section. Maybe after another few thousand attempts, it can learn. After another entire day of training, the AI appears to be ready to conquer its fear and starts attempting the dreaded corner. While it's still unable to make it, the AI will now spend more and more time practicing. After 225 hours of training, the AI continues its attempts, attacking the problem with every conceivable method you can imagine. Slowly but surely, it is edging its way closer to beating the dreaded corner. After 250 hours and starting from the respawn location just before the corner, at long, long last, the AI is finally able to conquer its greatest enemy. There's also a huge cluster of rewards right after that corner, meaning the AI quickly makes work of the rest of the track. Just like that, the AI is able to complete not just that corner and every single track. Anyway, I know what you've all been waiting for, so it's time we skip to the end to see the final AI after 500 long hours of training. But first, be sure to click that like button, comment a question or something you liked about the video for the algorithm, and of course, don't forget to subscribe. The AI was successfully able to get a podium place on every single track in the entire game, even including Rainbow Road and Bowser's Castle. Here we can see the overall graph of training, showing that after 700 million frames of Mario Kart, this AI was still improving. You may also wonder what this large spike in progress was at around 250 hours. Well, since we were forcing the AI to play tracks it was bad at, what happens when it is bad at no tracks? After the AI could finish Rainbow Road, the AI now completed every track it played, meaning a large surge in reward. Much to the AI's relief, it finally meant that AI could begin to play other tracks and not just Rainbow Road. Here, you can see the final graph for every individual track. You may notice just how much this AI was forced to play Rainbow Road. The AI played around 1,000 races of a short track like Luigi Circuit, compared to around 12,000 for Rainbow Road. However, there were certainly some other tracks that AI did battle with. I think it's worth an honorary mention to Wii and N64 Bowser's Castle, Dry Dry Ruins, and Maple Treeway, which all took over 4,000 attempts. While this AI was successfully able to play every track in the whole game, sadly, this AI wasn't quite perfect. The AI did make a lot of mistakes and looked a little sloppy at times. Once again, this was a product of the rewards that we gave the AI. Since the AI's reward would stay high so long as it didn't get reset, that was all it really focused on. The AI also didn't really care that much about getting first. While I did reward the AI based on its finishing position, this was much smaller than that of making it around the track. When learning to drive on many different tracks, I'd argue focusing on your position isn't really the key idea. Not to sound too stoic, but it's better for the AI just to focus on what it controls, rather than what the other racers are doing. Of course, when trying to create an AI that can obliterate CPUs at a single course, this becomes much, much more important. I hope you enjoyed the journey of seeing a self-taught AI beat the entire game of Mario Kart Wii. I hope this video made your day just a little bit better, and I hope to see you again in the next one.